Welcome back to Larry King Live. I'm Larry King, and these suspenders are prescription. They hold in my organs. In the hour ahead, sex scandals dominating the news cycle. How do powerful men like Roman Polanski, John Phillips, Mark Sanford, and David Letterman become entangled in these sordid circumstances? And why are we so fascinated by their stories? I'm joined via satellite by CNN media analyst Carly Lane.
Hello, Larry.
Syndicated columnist Jefferson Mitchell.
Hello.
And professor of electronic media and technoculture at Columbia University, Dr. Eleanor Pearson.
What's up, Larry?
Carly, let's start with you. It seems we've been hearing a lot about one sex scandal after another lately. What is going on?
Well, Larry, I think it all boils down to the fact that men like to put their wieners inside things.
Interesting. Interesting. So I guess the real question is, why would a man put his wiener somewhere where he shouldn't? Jefferson.
Well, I think the lesson we've all learned from these scandals is that men have a real tough time controlling their wieners. Look at Elliot Spitzer, John Ensign, Larry Craig, all powerful men, all taken down by their wieners.
But why the intense media focus on these stories?
Well, let me tell you something. Men love knowing what other men are doing with their wieners. It's almost as good as doing things with your own wiener. It's fun to have conversations like, he did what with his wiener? And, I would never put my wiener where that guy put his wiener.
You know whose wiener I'd like to know more about? The great Hal Holbrook.
Larry, if you're a celebrity and you've done something embarrassing with your wiener, that's all the public remembers. Like John Edwards, he was a distinguished senator, but I mostly remember him for his wiener.
John Edwards was a senator?
Wait, John Edwards, the wiener guy?
See, this proves my point. All you guys care about is his wiener.
Oh.
You're
oh,
right, I do.
It's very true.
Sorry about that.
Yeah. Guilty. You're watching Larry King. The topic tonight, powerful men and their wieners. Carly, do wiener stories help sell the newspapers?
Yes, but let me add that wiener print media is struggling right now. People get more and more of their news from the internet, which I don't have to tell you is full of wieners. I call it the wiener net. In fact, there's a blog where a guy literally draws wieners on his celebrity photos, and it's really popular.
That sounds really funny. Well, we want to hear what you think, America. Cast in your vote on the CNN poll. Today's question, where should men be allowed to put their wieners? Text one for everywhere, two for nowhere, and three for it depends on who or what they are putting their wieners into. I like three's chances. Jefferson, a final thought.
Look, a lot of guys do bad stuff with their wieners. I can't speak for all wieners, but historically, they usually want to go where they shouldn't.
I can speak for mine. That's true.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, mine also. But, you know, we have to be able to distinguish between relatively harmless things that guys do with their wieners and really terrible things. So we have a reasonable standard to judge them by. Like, say, John Phillips would be a 10 on the bad wiener scale, and Letterman would be a 2. Okay? Now, Polanski is a 9 or a European 4.
I like that. An international wiener conduct rating system. Eleanor.
Frankly, I just want to hear more wiener stories. And I especially want to see more pictures of the ladies who have touched famous wieners because I love comparing myself physically to them.
Carly.
I just think it's sad that our culture is so preoccupied with famous wieners. I mean, while there's real news going on unreported, I mean, the situation in Afghanistan is a mess. It's like a wiener that's been hit with a hammer.
That's a pretty harrowing final image. And that's it for tonight's show. Thanks to all my guests. Tomorrow night, I'll be joined by the lovely and talented Angie Dickinson. And you can bet my wiener will be there.